Veterans Day originated as Armistice Day on November 11, 1990, the first anniversary of the end of World War I. Congress passed a resolution in 1926 for an annual observance, and November 11 became a national holiday beginning in 1938. Unlike Memorial Day, Veterans Day pays tribute to all American veterans living or dead, but especially gives thanks to living veterans who served their country honorably. Come forward and introduce the Viking Corral and Senora Spanish.
Thank you. Scotland Army.
But not least, United States Air Force.
And I have a little problem. I retired in 1986 out of the Army. And I look out here and this thing gets a little tighter. Now, I don't know if you blame it on the closet, the laundry, or the good service. And for you guys as veterans, you're being protested. Okay. This is a call to POW MIA Remembrance Service. And those who have served and currently serving in the undeployed services of the United States are ever mindful of the sweetness and the endurance of the countries. And we've been taunted by the bitterness of the personal sacrifice. We are compelled to never forget that we, while we enjoy our daily pleasures, there are others who have endured and may still be enduring the agonies of pain in prison. Before we begin our activities, we pause to recognize our POW. We call your attention to the small table, which occupies a place of dignity and honor. It is set for one, symbolizing the fact that the members of our armed forces are missing from our ranks. And they are referred as a POW or MIA, POW Prisoner of War, MIA. We call them comrades. They are unable to be with us, be with their loved ones and families, so we join together to pay a tribute to them, giving farewell to their continued absence. The table is small, symbolizing the fidelity of one prisoner at home and guest appearance of surprises. The tablecloth is white, symbolizing the purity of their intentions to respond to their country call for arms. The single nose in the face signifies the blood that they may have shed and sacrificed to ensure the freedom of our beloved United States of America. The rose also reminds us of the family and friends of the missing comrades who keep faith while awaiting their return. The red ribbon around the base represents the red which were on the labels of thousands who delayed with the unyielding determination a proper account of our comrades who are not among us. A slice of lemon on the plate reminds us of their better fate. The salt sprinkled around the plate reminds us of the countless volunteers of the families visiting late. The glass is inverted. They cannot toast for the sickest. The chair is empty. They are not here. The candle reminds us the American flag reminds us of the many of them who may never return and have made the supreme sacrifice to ensure our freedom. Let us pay respect to the supreme commander of all of our comrades who are still alive. And let us remember and never forget their sacrifice. May God forever watch over them and protect their families. Thank you.
Thank you. to ensure that their sacrifices can never fail. So let's take this opportunity to honor, thank, and remember the Institute of Temple Services. I want to thank all of the veterans for serving up in the country. We are all very grateful for all of your sacrifices. Not just on Veterans Day, but each and every day. We are grateful and appreciate everything you have done to help keep us the foundation and the underlying of the community. It is a very real value for us. Thank you, Veterans, for your service.
Thank you, Mr. Stein. Now, Mr. Dantas would like to come forward and sing taps.
All is ready.